Pumped About This Video. As Pen as Penee always says. Hey guys, this is Are, and I'm super enthusiastic about this video because this is the first video I will be shooting on my new Sony ZV-1 camera that you're now watching on. So that means, hopefully, that everything is crisp and clear. It also means that you can see the red spots here in my neck. That has to do because we now have a caterpillar attack here in the Netherlands. And ladies and gentlemen, they got me. So, but we now move on to the three service devices that we have now in front of me. This video is going to be about the form factors of the Surface family. I will help you choose the right form factor for you. We go on about all the different kind of types of user case scenarios that you can use a Surface for. For example, the Surface Pro 7 with the tablet form factor and the type cover. And then we move on to the Surface laptop, more traditional clamshell laptop. This one is an Alcantara. And the Surface Book. This is a two-in-one device that you can attach from the keyboard. So stay tuned. I have to say I'm a little bit biased though because I've worked for Microsoft as a service category manager after I graduated. I'm not working there anymore. Enjoy this video, guys. So, you are still here. That's a good thing to be sure. So, we start this video off with my favorite form factor. Yeah, I'm a little bit biased. With the Surface Pro form factor. In this family, it falls the Surface Pro 7, Surface Pro X, and also a little bit the Surface Go 2, because it has the same form factor. Not the same performance as the Surface Pro or the Pro X, but that will come in a later video. Form factor of the Surface Pro series became a success around the Surface Pro 3. Before that, I had the Surface Pro 1 and the Pro 2, but that they were way too thick to make use of the new way of working with the PC. Couple of specs. This one comes in i3, i5, i7, 4 GB of RAM, 8 GB of RAM, 16 GB of RAM. It is a 12.3 pixel sense display and it has a lot of pixels, namely 2736 by 1824 pixels. Should have known it by now, but okay. This is the most versatile form factor of the three form factors that we'll be discussing in this video, because you have the tablet mode, like I'm holding right now. You have the normal laptop mode, and then you have the studio mode. Then you can just kick out the kickstand and then you can draw on it. Very nice. And that's why I'm so in love with this form factor, because it enables you to what I call the new way of working with a PC. The whole idea of the Surface Pro was in 2013 when the Pro 3 was announced, that this device can bridge a gap between the digital world and the not digital world. For example, if a designer is designing a product, normally he would sketch on a paper and then have to hardwire it into a program like SolidWorks. There's no freedom to sketch freely and to express your creativity, basically. So with the Surface Pro, you can combine the best of both worlds, because you can sketch on this device and you can also use SolidWorks. So you don't lose your notes, because all your notes are digitally in OneNote, for example. They don't get wrinkled, etc., etc. So bridging the gap between the digital world and the non-digital world. I also did an internship for Microsoft, a sort of like a UX research internship, where I covered this subject. How can we enable this new way of working with the PC with the Surface Pro for students? I did a research with a couple of end user goals, like is it more convenient to print out a paper or to have a form factor like this and have it always with you. So in conclusion, this form factor enables me to have more interaction with the content that I'm using. I can touch the screen, I can quickly transform if I need to be reading a PDF in the train or read a book. And I don't print anything anymore because of this form factor. So when I go to a meeting, I only take my Surface Pro with me, and there are all my notes and the agenda for that meeting, etc., etc. This can also be done with the Surface Book, but in my opinion, it's less convenient because you have to wait a couple of seconds. And when you're starting up a meeting, people are in a hurry and things need to be over quickly. So a couple of seconds can matter a lot. And in terms of usability, things need to react quickly. Otherwise, people are not going to use it. A couple of other examples of how you can interact with your stuff. You can mark some text PDF document. You can then rotate the whole tablet vertically. This form factor enables the new way of working with a PC, especially with a pen, the most. A couple of examples for this new way of working with a PC. With Word, you have like an editor, an intelligent editor. Text, it automatically directs the yellow markings to the text. And you can, if you want to scrap a text, you can just write over it, and then Word knows, okay, the editor wants this to be deleted. Otherwise, you didn't put a cross through the text. So that were a couple of examples. And typing on the type cover is almost just as good as typing on a regular laptop. Microsoft has put a lot of work into developing these type covers, and that it has enough travel that it feels just like a normal keyboard. And it feels especially nice with the Alcantara. Actually, it has more travel than the latest MacBook. Before the upgraded to normal switches. Touchpad is also quite nice. All the surface form factors, it supports a precision touchpad. That means that it supports multiple finger input. 2 fingers up, 2 fingers down, 3 fingers left, 3 fingers right, swipe, etc., etc. If you are a person that travels a lot, is mobile a lot, and wants to make use of the new way of working with a PC, then go for a Surface Pro, because you can easily switch from a tablet to a laptop to studio mode and vice versa. Then we move on to maybe the most beautiful form factor that the Surface line has to offer. There you go again, looking so handsome. Oh, you have your way, and it's making me weaken. You and your status, walking like that. This is the Surface Laptop 3, 13 inch. And I have to say, whoopsie, I fell in love with the traditional form factor. I don't know, because it's still convenient, man. I mean, look at this. One finger and it directly turns on. There are definitely some pros to the traditional clamshell laptop. And especially when Microsoft designs it, because it has Alcantara. That's very nice. So it has, same as all the other Surface devices, it has a 3:2 aspect ratio. It has a lot of pixels, namely 20/20/56 by 1504. That is a pixel density of 201 pixels. It has also a touchscreen, also suitable for the Surface Pen. But the thing is, you can't flip the screen, so it's kind of awkward to write on. Don't write on this device. But it's nice that it can, right? So let's just move on. This device comes in a 13.5 variant and a 15 inch variant. This one comes with an i5 or an i7 of the 10th generation Intel processors. 13.5 inch comes with an Intel Iris Plus graphics, same as the Surface Pro basically, but the 15-inch comes with an AMD graphics card. So you can game a little bit on it. Don't expect 4K, but you can play a little bit more than on a Surface laptop or a Surface Pro. Then we move on to the most important stuff. What is the UX of this form factor? Like I just said, this is a normal traditional clamshell laptop. The thing is, I really love it. If you want to buy another tablet or maybe a Surface Go to enable the new way of working with the PC, like I just covered in the Surface Pro part of this video, then I can totally live with it. But if I'm being honest, it was really convenient to get this out of my bag in the park, in the train, when I'm walking. The battery life was excellent. I actually used this USB-C a lot, normal USB-A port, a USB-C port, even a headphone jack, smartphone makers, and a Surface Connect port. So yeah, what do you expect from a normal laptop? Basically, this device enables the way of working with a PC like any other laptop would. But it has one advantage, that it's really nice built. I mean, you can open it with one hand. Yeah, I know, I hear all the Apple people saying, we have had that for 8 years. Okay, yeah, but Microsoft is, this is only the third generation of Surface laptop, so. What kind of a person needs the Laptop 3 Surface form factor? If you don't need all the stuff of working the new way with a PC that I just covered in the Surface Pro part of this video, and you don't need to take notes, you only will be needing a very, very nice keyboard, because the keyboard is amazing. The touchpad is now extra large in the Surface. And if you just want to use this as a normal, regular laptop that is super fast with a super nice SSD, you can open it and it directly starts Windows, then just go for a traditional clamshell laptop. I came from the mud, there's dirt on my hands. Strong like a tree, there's roots where I stand. Oh, I've been running from the law. Hope they won't shoot me down soon. So, if you want unlimited power. You need to be looking for the Surface Book form factor. This is actually the odd one out, because this is a Book 2, by the way. Unfortunately, Microsoft couldn't send me the Book 3 in time. Doesn't matter, because this video is about the form factor. I've been using this one since 2018 non-stop, and ever since I've been making YouTube videos, needing the external graphics card a lot more, I've been loving this device way more, because sometimes you'll be needing that raw unlimited power. Like, what is the Surface Book? This one, normally it comes in i5 and i7. It starts with 8 GB of RAM, 60 GB of RAM, and goes up 32 GB of RAM. So this device is a powerhouse meant for creators. If you want to create stuff, for example, you're running Photoshop all day long, editing a video, you can even game a little bit on it. I've been gaming the Master Chief Collection and Sea of Thieves. This is a Ultrabook processor that is in tablet portion, because you can, same like the Surface Pro form factor, you can detach the screen and then it clicks and then you can take it off. But that takes a couple of seconds when you're in a meeting. Sometimes it just takes too long, and it sometimes seems that Windows is a little bit more sluggish on the Surface Book than on my Surface Pro. But maybe that has to do because you, yeah, basically take out 50% of the whole, nah, that's not true. You take out a whole video card and a couple of batteries, boom, out of Windows, and just Windows has to deal with it. Like, what is going on? But okay, fine. Maybe that has something to do with it. I've been writing like a lot of notes on this device for my pre-masters, and sometimes it's more convenient, at least for me. But I had like a statistics subject, and it's for me way more convenient and easier to understand to write the formula than just to type it in. You have way more freedom. And the thing is, if you're writing down, if you're a student, It forces you to summarize what your teacher is saying and not like typing everything over that he or she says, like a robot, like a. That's not the way to do it. Oh, I forgot something to say. With the source book, the pen can be attached on the side, same as the Surface Pro. With the laptop, this is not possible. You have to carry it around loose in your bag like a crazy person. The screen resolution of the Surface Book 2 is 3000 by 2000 pixels, and it's even higher on the 15-inch. Then what is the UX about of this form factor? Okay, let's just compare it to the smoothness of opening up the Surface Laptop 3. If you open it up with one finger, it can be done, but it takes a lot of practice. I remember when I just got the Surface Book 1, I was like, okay, how do you open this? Oh, here's a little... Yeah, okay, it's open. That is to do because this is a very lovely designed hinge. But if you're coming from a traditional laptop, you need to get used to it, basically. Keep in mind that this tablet is way heavier than a traditional clamshell screen, because there are a lot of components are in the tablet portion. Basically everything except for the battery and the video card. So for who is this device then? Are you a creator and you don't want to be running a Mac? You love the new way of working with a PC, what I just described with the touchscreen, the fact that you don't have to carry all your notes, that you can write on it, that you can use the dial, for example, to change colors. If you like to be sketching, but you do need that extra power, that extra graphical power. For this one, it is an NVIDIA 1050. In the 15-inch, there's a way more powerful video card. But if you do need that extra raw unlimited power, then just go for the Surface Book. And this one has insane battery life. Some games I just go up to 15 hours without charging. That is not when I'm gaming. When I'm gaming, the battery life just like whoop. What is my conclusion then about the form factor that is ideal for you? Short answer, I don't know. You have to decide that for yourself. But I would pick the Surface Pro any day over the other form factors. That has to do because I don't need the unlimited raw power of the Surface Book 3 or 2 all the time on the road. I do have a desktop here where I do most of my edits and a little bit of gaming on. When I go out, I normally go out for a meeting or a lecture or etc. because I will be a new media design master student in late August. And there you do a lot of project work and light design work. For example, making a UX prototype. So basically then you have way enough power with you with the Surface Pro 7. And you can even do some light editing on the go with Surface Pro 7. But this is personal, like I just said. So you can make your own choice. Are you a mobile person and you would love to enjoy the tablet / studio / laptop form factor and would like to interact with the pen more, go for the Pro. If you just want a very nice device and want it to be designed perfectly, open it with one hand, have the Alcantara or the aluminium, then go for the Surface Laptop 3 form factor. Or do you need the raw unlimited power and do want to enjoy the Surface Pro abilities, go for the Surface Book 2 or 3. So this is my conclusion. Stay tuned for other videos. And guys, please like and subscribe this video, because I only need 6 more subscribers and then I'll reach 100. And this enables me to go to a lot of companies like, hey, I want to review your product with my kind of style, my viewers enjoy my style, etc., etc., etc. So please like and subscribe or share this video. Okay, future editing Ari here. I want to give a very special thanks to Marco and Noelle from Microsoft the Netherlands for making this video possible by lending me all the beautiful Surface devices that you saw in this video. Also, a special thanks to my cousin, Igor Jelissen, for helping me to shoot all those very nice, crisp and clear B-roll shots that you saw. A lot of love for the community. This was Are. Cheers.